about $100 shirt at the Steel Movie store. Guess what? I spent another $6,000 all day, man. Squad team, man. What's up, man? Still moving, baby.
Guess who?
This is a Mosky production. Mosky production. Mosky production.
This is Sahara and Valley View.
Yeah. That's the busiest corridor you have right now.
Straight down, you're back on right where we came from, what's Spring Mountain Valley.
Yeah, we open up Monday, man.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We got to lock some things down, but I'll holler at y'all, boys.
All right, do your thing.
Yeah, so basically me and Dizzy have been friends since day one. I mean, we both obviously grew up in Vegas. We both came from somewhere else, but definitely made our roots and our ground here. So I know he went to Basic, I went to Green Valley, so we know each other from way back. Our relationship kind of just evolved from him just, you know, kind of supporting everything that I was doing and the movements that I was doing, and definitely supporting, you know, him as well and what he was doing for the city and becoming a great face for, you know, Vegas and our hometown, man. So basically he would come into other shops I had like new and buy a bunch of clothes, especially before a tour, and I would hook him up definitely to make sure he was repping the brand and, you know, showcasing what we had. That's how kind of we built our relationship a little bit stronger at that sense. And then from there, I went on to Reef Dispensaries, where our relationship definitely blossomed, and we were able to get, you know, all his strains into the store, Dizzy Lotto, Dizzy OG, Dizzy Dream, and from there, our relationship just built more of a business relationship as opposed to just a friendship. Santa Boy's on the bottom, and that cute. And I'm gonna put hats back to back, so you can see it from this side, and you can see it from that side.
Perfect.
So it's shoppable. The mannequin's gonna go in that empty slot, and then that's it, bro. Folded Still Moving t-shirts on the table with Still Moving tees.
We open in 45 minutes.
2013, dropped a record called Still Moving on the Golden Age Project. It really connected and resonated with the people, and we kind of turned it into a lifestyle thing. And then it just grew and blossomed into what it is today. I just knew Angel had a great business mind. He was like running a store in Vegas already, always looked out for me. I just like how he moved and finessed and you know, his rhythm and everything. And I, when it was time for me to open up a store and, you know, make my footprints in the game, I knew I had to hit him and get some advice. And luckily in that time period, he wanted to be a business owner as well. So we was able to put our minds together and create Still Moving.
Come on, man, let's get it.
It's going, bro.
Wait, hold on. Where Dizzy at, man? Where Dizzy at, man? He told me he was gonna be up here. Dizzy. Hey, homie.
Hey, what's up?
You know, I was actually inspired by everything, by everybody whoever opened a business. When I was on tour, I just found myself being intrigued by everything that I had to start from ground zero at some point. You know, so big places, little places, family restaurants, food chains, whatever. I just felt like it all had to start from somewhere, from a thought, you know. None of it just popped out of thin air. It just like had to be thought about. And then I was inspired by that. And then I started, you know, looking at, you know, the artists that were, how many artists had stepped outside of, you know, music to do different things, like Diddy and, you know, Ciroc and Jigga and the Brooklyn Nets and, you know, Nipsey and the Marathon Clothing Store. And, you know, I was just inspired by everything in life. And I just wanted to, I was ready. I was ready to contribute and, you know, be able to call myself a business owner and really work for that and work to, you know, maintain that. So that's dope.
Bam!
We in business, baby.
Yeah, yeah.
Shining, man. We in. Oh, man. Still moving, baby. That's us.
And literally, me and Robbie have been friends for about 6 years now. Just knowing him through Agenda and the retail world, and have his own store in Tucson that's been open for about 9 years. He obviously had all this new exposure and clout with the Netflix show, so that was going really good for him. And he happened to just be in town watching good old Celine Dion. And when he was in town, he definitely came by and checked out the shop. We were open for about 6 months then, so he came by and checked out the shop in about February. And he asked me what I was doing with the space. We went over it and just thought it would be a great, great idea to bring Generation Cool to Vegas. Obviously, Vegas is a huge, huge tourist location, so we get a bunch of people from all over the world. So it was a perfect idea to help people get a feel and a presence of the store without having to go to such a destination spot like Tucson. It was March, so about 30 days later, we opened the store, crazy enough. So in 30 days, we were able to open up shop in Generation Cool, come up with a great concept and great idea. We do all 80s, 90s vintage over there, with Slobby Robbie, JR, and Zach being our partners on that side. And it's been going great, man. We're two individually funded independent businesses that have been growing and been getting great exposure. It was good to bring Generation Cool to Vegas to help home in on that vintage market and just basically have a place where people can kind of go and see and get a feel for the Generation Cool store.
So I'm about to lose my voice, but ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming. We're super excited to have you guys be here. I want to thank everybody for your support and your love. We're super excited to bring this project on behalf of Generation Cool. Thank you to Zach, thank you to Robbie, thank you to my man JR. Thank you guys so much on behalf of Dizzy and myself and Still Moving. Thank you for helping us keep the city live and helping it keep growing, man. We're excited to bring you guys some fly shit. So welcome, day one.
Yeah.
We wanted something that matched our vibe, but also added to the vibe and brought a little more to the table. And we wanted something that was fly and creative and different. And it was a milestone to accomplish that, you know, because sometimes everything, you know, can be random, or everything can be too similar, and the vibe's not different enough for it to be different, you know. So it worked out in our favor that Generation Cool was able to get in there. And yeah, we truck. We keep trucking, still moving.
Five, four, three, two, one.
this year has been great. It's definitely been an eye-opener. It's definitely been a stepping stone as well. I think with the second year coming up, we want to do so much more, especially with the brand. First, you know, we started off as just kind of having Disney merch and having store merch, and it's really evolved into its own brand now. People are asking for it, demanding it. We're definitely going to bring some of the products that we have dropped back in the past, like the Sweats Champion collab. Definitely going to do something new to it, but we'll definitely be dropping stuff like that. So expect a whole rollout of the brand, from men's tops and bottoms to women's finally being introduced. We want to show the ladies some love, and just event-wise, we're going to definitely go hard on that. We've usually been having an event every month, and now this last month it was like four with our Still Moving 1 year anniversary. So we definitely want to continue to build that atmosphere here that's an open place for creatives and artists to come together, share ideas, meet each other, create relationships, and kind of really just grow with each other. And I think this is the forefront of a place in Vegas that's really doing it. So we want to continue to do that, so growing as much as possible.
We still gonna collab with brands, and we still gonna pick brands up and put them in our store, and it's gonna be, we still gonna always have that fly stuff for y'all, but we're definitely gonna do a better job with, like, giving, you know, the city and the world classic one piece and one-offs and you know, shit that you're not gonna be able to see all the time, but you'll be able to think back, like, it'll be able to represent a cool time in your life. And everybody ain't gonna have it, you know, so we're gonna try to get really creative and do some cool different things. We still gonna carry all the fly shit, and, you know, we still gonna be throwing dope events and dope parties, and whatever we can do to be involved, we're gonna try to be involved. Still Moving the lifestyle, so we wanna live by that. Hey, man, God is good, man. 1 year and a bunch of more to come, man. To many more moons. Peace and love. Dizzy Wright, boo. I'm out.